Welcome to Junia's Cancer and ZenOnco.io. I'm Mansi from ZenOnco.io. This is our Cancer Healing Journey Talk, where we invite speakers who have gone through cancer, maybe as a patient, caregiver, or survivor. These CHAs are very close to our hearts because many patients tell us that when we listen to other people's journeys, it inspires us. It helps to boost their confidence and gives them hope that if others have been able to successfully beat the disease, then why can't they? So thank you very much for joining us for today's CHG talk. So Junia, can you please introduce yourself and tell us how did your journey started and how it all began?
Yeah, sure. I'm Dr. Junia Deborah. Have done my doctorate. So actually, basically, I'm from Kadalur. That is from Pondicherry. Right now, I'm working as an assistant professor in a private Christian college in Vellore. So actually, straight away, I just wanted to start the journey of my how I have came across all those things and all. So actually, basically, we were two siblings. And after my sister went to be with Lord, and then after immediately 5 years, and then in the year of 2013, so the symptoms has to slowly started arising, like loss of appetite, because previously I had a very long hair, that hair also getting lost day by day drastically. And then later on, and then my local doctor found that something is odd. And then immediately they sent me to some hospital in Chennai. And then there they have diagnosed that I got that Hodgkin's lymphoma. That is the classical Hodgkin's lymphoma with the stage 3. So at that time, yes. So at that time, doctors told me that almost the stage is 3. So somehow we will try to do our better. But anyways, others will be in the God's hands. Likewise, they have said. And then afterwards, I have moved to some other hospital, private hospital in Vellore. And then there I have started treated by the doctor in the hematology department. In the 2003, up to 8 or 9 months, I got treated with ABVD medications. And then throughout the journey, the pain was very much actually. It couldn't be, what is that? I don't know how to tell. It couldn't be expressible. That much pain I have gone through. My parents was with me. Because already I lost my younger sister, and then now I'm getting into this, so my parents are much worried. And then anyways, at the end of the treatment, I got cured, and then my remission has started, and then we have gone back to our own place, to Kadalur. And then I have started again working as a lecturer. And then again, after 1 year, I got those symptoms once again. But previously, doctor explained that most probably the Hodgkin's lymphoma of classical type won't be relapsing. But in my case, it has been like that. So after seeing all those symptoms, so I scared once again. And then we came back to Vellore, and then we checked with the doctors. And then they have confirmed that my disease has got relapsed once again. So the second time, I really fed up this time, because I don't know whether I will survive or not. Because this time, even doctors told me that this time, so we have to give you the high dose chemos. We don't know whether how much your body will be responding for that, like that they said. And then moreover, I was suggested for stem cell therapy. So at that time we were scared about that stem cell therapy, because doctors explained that I am the only child for my parent after my sister's loss, because mostly they were harvesting the stem cell from the sibling. Suppose right. If that person is not having that enough or the stem cell. So, but I'm a strong believer of God. So I was still praying and going through all those things. And then even in every phase of the high dose chemo, you know, I don't have any hope at all, but still, doctors and the nurses were around me, keep on encouraging me and saying like that, see, Junia, you could do well. Definitely, you will do well. You can come out of this. And then you will testify for so many people like that. They were keep on encouraging me, particularly. So I just wanted to mention my consultant name here. Initially, Dr. Aro Vishwabandia, right now, he's working in, Canada. And then another doctor named Dr. Fauzia, she's working in, CMC. She's a consultant in hematology. So I really wanted to mention their name here because they encouraged me. And then they also traveled with me toward this journey by encouraging. And then after the treatment, no, and then the stem cell part has started. So at that time, they have said me, so we'll try to harvest that stem cell from your body. And then from your blood, and then otherwise we have to go for hetero. That is, we have to get it from someone, some other thing. Like, I was scary because I'm not much my parents, and I'm not much affordable for those costs and all. And then we were waiting, and hopefully we are believing in God, and we are keep moving. We were at that time, and then after my harvesting, to the surprise. They have harvested more than the needed cells. That's what my consultant she told me that really, Junia, I'm very surprised to see this because already I have gone through so many chemos now, right from 2013 right. And then after that in 2015, because beam chemo was also given to me. So due to that, in order to destroy that cells and all. Mm-hmm. But she said that we have very rarely seen cases like this and all for like that. So I became very happy. So and then I have much confidence at that time. Okay, something is something good is going to happen in my life so that I could survive and testify for people, and then I could help out for people and all like that. And then 2015 December, my stem cell transplant was done.
Okay.
So usually doctors used to say within 18 days, that's 18 to 23 days, the cells will grow. That is the WBC or platelets or any other blood counts and all. And then surprisingly, within that 18 days itself, so all my cells has grown and came up to the good level, then normal level. So, and then in that phase also, see, doctor said, it's all your, confidence and your response, your body's responding to the treatment. And then moreover, your belief and all, everything and all, they said. And then after that stem cell transplant, and then they have asked me to come for the regular review. Each and every month I have to come for the review. But anyways, they asked me to stay in Vellore itself for up to 3 months. So because anyways, the body's immunity power will be very low, no? Suppose if I get any infections, I should travel. I could not travel all the way from Padlo to here. That's why they asked me to stay here. And then we stayed there. Then suddenly they asked me to take that, radiation treatment. So previously I was not informed about that radiation treatment. So I was much scared and asked them about this. See, actually, why should I get that radiation treatment and all? Because already I have gone through all those treatments. And then they said, no, it's just for your for your safety. And then already we have done everything. This is also for, because I got that lymph node in this mediastinal area. So they said that some dot will be there. So for that sake, we are giving this radiation and all. They said, they explained. And then after, I think, probably 30 days, 30 days of minimum minutes only, they have given that radiation. So after that, they asked me to take rest for a while. And it's for about 6 months. So rest for a while. And then they advised me to go step out slowly. And then they asked me to do some exercise and all everything. So one thing I just wanted to add here. So before getting into treatment, I got registered with my PhD doctorate in Coimbatore. So after that radiation treatment, we just vacated Vellore and we came back to our hometown. So from there, immediately we have started what is it? We have started my journey towards my PhD. So one day we started traveling towards Coimbatore, that is to my university. So at that time, see, just after leaving our home, 1 hour after, our car stuck. What is it? It's not stuck. Some bus tire got burst and it hit our car. And then we met with a very bad accident. So actually, the car has crashed completely. But to the surprise, my mother, father, and the driver has doesn't have any wound in their body. But I don't know. Unluckily, I don't know whether. But my head has got injured very badly. So this is a scar in my head. So right from here to here, and then yes, because day three has came out, but I was stuck inside the car, and then it was on highway. It has happened in the highways, and then people from the toll gate and the police, everyone ran towards us, and then they took me out after breaking the glass because I was stuck inside the dickey, that the backside of the car, and then they have took me out. And then they took me to the local hospital, but I have informed them, please don't give any medication. Instead, please send me back to my hospital. And then it will take 4 to 5 hours from there to here. But anyways, that ambulance man, no, that driver, he took me within 3.5 hours to this hospital because at that time, what is it, blood was coming out from my ears and then, what is that, everything and all, so much blood loss from my head. So already due to that treatment, I was very weak. At that time, I don't have hair in my head also. So I got injured. So and then in my neck also some little bit injury was there, and then total body pain. With the total body pain, they have took me to here, and then in this hospital, and then they took me for every test and all. And then initially they said that, see, Junior, you need to undergo some surgery like that because that blood was shedding from my ears and all. They said me initially. Without taking any test before that, they said, and then it seems to be some 2 to 3 more fractures would be probably inside your body and all, they said, and then they kept something, so many things in my body, and then with my belief, I just prayed and kept silent, and then after half an hour, and then they took me to the, what is it, inside that, what is it, scan room, scan, and then X-ray. They took a blood test. Everything, all the tests was done, and then again I have sent back to the casualty. And then after half an hour, at that time my cousin was working there. They all ran to me, and then they started cleaning this injury, and he started putting the suture. And then I was asking him, see, you said so many injuries are there and there. I need some surgery and all. Then what was going on? I said, see, he said, Akka, surprisingly, I just wanted to say you. See, there was no, what is it, not even a single air crack in your body. Everything is fine. So, no need of blood transfusion and all. They said, I'm really surprised to see that. And then the doctor, that particular casualty doctor, also came back to me. He also said that, see, sister, actually, that blood was flowing from your head. That not actually from your ears, so no need to worry about that. So all your tests are very normal, so nothing to worry. Just we'll put the suture and then you go back. You just come daily for this for cleaning this injury and all. And then after all these things, no, at that time only, I was thinking and thinking about me. I used to think and meditate about me, see what is the purpose of my life, and then why God has created and sent me to this world. And at that time, I realized the worth of my life. So all above all these things, I'm still alive now because there would be some purpose behind that. So I came to know that purpose about that. Then again, my guide, Dr. Lata Parthiban from Pondicherry, and then she encouraged me to and then do my PhD, continue my PhD. So I thought that whether I could not whether I could complete my PhD or not. But then, but my parents and my cousins and especially my guide, and then she encouraged me. She nothing worse than this, Junia. You can do your PhD. I'll be helping you out. Definitely, I'll be with you in this regard. That she helped me a lot throughout that. So after 7 years, so last July only I have completed my doctorate. So actually after the treatment, after starting that working with the PhD, so parallelly I have joined a counseling course in CMC. So there I got a very good experience in counseling with cancer patients. So I became very happy because ordinary people can go and counsel them, but if I stand in front of them, no, I am the testimony. I am a survivor. I mean, I am an overcomer of the what is that, cancer. The sense then people started admiring. See, they will be asking me, ma'am, whether I will be also like you. Whether I will be asking, they started liking that. And then I'm not much good in languages. I know Tamil and English. I could manage somehow. So people come over here are good in Hindi and Bangla. So I'm not much familiar with that language, but even though with that sign language and thoda Hindi, no, I know something. Within that, I could able to encourage them, and then I could counsel them. So right from that 2016 and then up to now, I got opportunity to counsel so many cancer patients, and then counsel them, I'll comfort them, and then sometimes I go with them to hospital. So I used to go to a hospital and visit them, even if they need any physical help, no. So I'm just doing that for them. So I love to be with the cancer patients. So I just wanted to tell them, you can also survive like me, and then you can also testify and help so many people like that and all. And then just 2 years before, I have joined in college in Bellur, and then I have started teaching for students. I am just working in the department of PCA, so I am teaching the computer science and all. And then even I could testify to my students, so they are also get encouraged. And then some students are helping out with me. Suppose if I am going to visit any patients, so they are also coming along with me, and then we all together go and help them and all. So, and then moreover, I just, after seeing that ZenOnco in the social media and all, no, I just wanted to immediately contact you people to share my testimony, so that it could be useful to so many people
right,
who are looking at me. So really, I thank you, ZenOnco. Thank you so much for giving your wonderful time, this opportunity.
Thank you so much, Junia. Thanks for your time, because it's hard to find, and it's very rare to find such patients, such survivors, those who really want to give back to the society. And
yeah,
it's really inspiring to listen from you that you are also started, you also started counseling other people and
yeah,
other patients, which is very inspiring and encouraging as
okay,
well. So
okay,
yeah, it's actually, it's good to know that you have also taken part of other people's journey.
Yeah.
So can you please tell me that did you also make any lifestyle changes during or after the treatment, for example, diet or exercise?
Actually, I'm just taking that natural diet only. I'm just following just natural diet. But so I started avoiding the junk foods and all. But nowadays, I'm just taking, just because for the sake of my students, sometimes I used to go with my friends and all, no?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, students. So sometimes I used to take, burger, like that things and all. Otherwise, I'm just very conscious about my diet. But I'm not doing any exercises. But whenever I go for checkup now, my doctor used to advise me, Junia, I have to check up. You have to what is it, do some exercises. And then because my weight is now 54, she asked me, because I'm 150 only, my height is just 150. She asked me to reduce my weight, but I'm doing some household works because I'm staying alone here. My parents are in my hometown. So I'm doing, even though I'm doing my household works, but weight is not getting reduced. I have to keep up some exercises, but I'm not following it.
Yes, exercises are very important.
Okay.
And so can you please tell me, did you have any family history of cancer as well?
Family history in the sense, my father's siblings had, two of them had different kind of cancers, but not this kind of related. Yeah.
Okay.
And my father's sibling also had, my father's sister had breast cancer. And recently, she's also a survivor. I don't know, because my case, I asked doctor, they said this Hodgkin lymphoma, the kind of, they said, we don't, I'm not sure whether it might be a inheritance or not, like they said, I don't know.
Okay. And did you face any side effects as well or any issues during your cancer journey?
Yeah, of course. After the chemo, some chemo, I don't know the name of that chemo. My ears, I couldn't hear properly at that time. My hearing capacity has got reduced. So then doctors decided to change the chemo. So at that time, they have changed the chemo. And then my face also becomes much darker after the radiation. It was given here only, but still, when compared to my body and my face, the complexion differs actually. They told me that after 2 years only, your face will change. But after 7.5 years now, I'm already, the remission 7.5 years now, but still, very slowly, my face is getting lighter. But some kind of that is a not major side effect, just I had that hearing part. And then my periods also got disturbed. So for that I went to I met gynae outside in Chennai, GG hospital, and then they took care, and then they got they treated for that, and now I'm fine. I'm getting my periods.
Okay, so what were your top three learnings from this journey, if you could tell us?
Top three learnings. Yeah, I could say, see, life is, so we should not get scared about, I don't know what to tell, because my heart is filled with joy. I couldn't get any vocabulary. What to say? Please don't fed up if you get cancer.
Right.
Cancer is nothing at all. When you see that cancer, hey, you are nothing at all, man. I can face you like that, no? People started their journey by saying, I got this. No, please don't go in that way. You just talk to that cancer. Hey, you are nothing at all. I can overcome you. Like that we could say. That is thing, the confidence level I have learned. And then second thing I have learned that even though if people get cancer, they should not scare about that. They could face, they could survive, and they could live, and even they could help out for the people.
So what message will you give to cancer patients and caregivers?
Yeah, please don't be scary. Please be happy. Be energetic, have good, good diet, have good exercises. And then, please, one thing I especially wanted to add, please, cancer survivors and then and the caregivers, you just please follow the people, whomever comes to you. You just guide them, counsel them, be with them, lift them up, and make them to, make them to lift some of the cancer survivor.
Right. And if you could sum up your journey in just one sentence, sorry, in one sentence, then what that would be?
In one sentence, like some, what is it? Quote, like, no?
According to you, whatever you like.
Okay. Suddenly I got it. Okay. Life is full with challenges,
right.
But I overcame it.
It's perfect. Perfect for your journey. And I really like how optimistic you were throughout your journey. And even now, you are helping other people as well, other patients as well. So
Okay.
it was really inspiring listening to you. And thank you very much for sharing your experiences with us. I'm sure this
Okay.
would help so many cancer patients, caregivers, and survivors who
Yeah.
are listening to us and they are with us. And wish you all the best in all your future endeavors. Please take
Thank
care of
you.
yourself.